All right, as many of you know, I run my Plex Media Server from my Synology NAS, my network attached storage server, which has its own little way of managing packages and programs to run compared to a normal computer. And sometimes when the Plex Media Server app updates, a new package isn't always distributed to the Synology NAS in order to get updated. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to manually update it so that you can stay on top of some of the latest features. This video is, as always, sponsored by Plex. We do sponsored monthly Plex tutorials, as it's a great service that I use, and why not? I like showing you how to do things. So when you open up Plex and you go to your server settings, if you're running it on a Synology NAS, you're going to see an update is available, but please install manually. If you click that, it will download a Linux-based installer for Plex Media Server, and you will notice here the distro is Synology, which is kind of funny. Go ahead and download that installer file, and I went ahead and saved it to a folder on that NAS, so that way I can access it from the server. Go ahead and close Plex, because in your Synology NAS here, you will need to go to your package center, go to installed packages, find Plex, and tell it to stop because you can't update it while it's running. Next, go ahead and see where it says manual install. If you don't see that, go back to the main just package center option, but it should be here. Click manual install, browse to find that file. Oh, it will actually let you choose it from your local computer, so you do not need to save it to your NAS. That was just something I chose to do for no reason, apparently. Choose that installer file, hit next. Wait for it to do its thing. This package is published by an unknown publisher. Hit yes as long as you downloaded it directly through Plex. You, of course, don't want to download it from some other shady website. That could pose a security risk to your network storage. There you go. Developer, Plex Inc. It's the Plex Media Server, newest version. Hit apply. Updating. All right, now if we go to Plex Media Server here, you will see we are on that latest version. Actually, it says we're newer than the latest version available from Plex, but we're on that latest version. And if you go back, you actually see the install date of September 27th, which is the date of recording. Now go ahead and tell it to run again, so that way you can access it, of course. It's going to take a minute, and then tell it to open. And once it finishes loading, because I told it to open a little bit too early, you got to give it a second to kick in, you'll be able to access your newly updated Plex server. There we go. Select user, I'm going to log in. By the way, last month I showed you how to set up multiple users. And if we go to server settings, we're going to be up to date, which is pretty cool. And now you are updated and ready to rock with the latest server features, with latest account, whatever you need to get going on your Synology NAS, which I think is pretty cool. They always roll out some new features and yada yada. It's good idea to stay up to date, or at least after the updates have come out, after a little while. If you want to try out Plex for yourself, I have a free link, a paid link, and if you want to pay for someone else to have a Plex Pass account, all of those are in the description down below. Please use them if you want to sign up. It gives a kickback to the channel to let them know that we're sending you and to keep sponsoring these tutorials, that kind of thing. Otherwise, subscribe for more awesome tech education, like the video, share it with your friends, whatever. I'm going to go watch some movies and finish updating my MacBook to Mojave. Mojave. I don't know. I just wanted the dark theme. It's 2018 and they're only just enabling dark theme color coding for the radio buttons, which was a thing in Linux already. And Safari is only just now getting favicons, website icons for their web browser, something that we had back in like 1998.